This is one of my favorite demonstrations. We're going to look at the differences in reactivity down a family and across a row. You can see we have a selection of alkaline metals and alkaline earth metals. Each of these dishes has phenolphthalein in to indicate if there's a basic reaction. Let's start with lithium. The reaction between alkaline metals and water is spontaneous. It generates a base, lithium hydroxide, and hydrogen gas. You can see it's so vigorous that the lithium skitters around the dish. Next, let's take a look at sodium. Do we expect sodium to be more or less reactive than lithium? Sodium is much more vigorous than lithium. You can hear the sizzling. Again, it produces a hydroxide, in this case sodium hydroxide, and hydrogen gas. Now let's take a look at potassium. Potassium is in a big beaker, and I have a screen for the top of it.
Just like the other reactions, this one also produces hydrogen gas. But the reaction is so vigorous it lights the hydrogen gas on fire. The purple color you see is from the potassium ions.
Now let's take a look at the alkaline earth metals. We'll start with magnesium. You can see there's not much of a reaction. But let's take a look at calcium. Since calcium is further down the periodic table, we would expect it to be more reactive than magnesium. And you can see just the start of a pink color, indicating the presence of calcium hydroxide. When the alkali metal reactions are complete, we can see that they're all the same beautiful shade of phenolphthalein.